welcome back to Danganronpa School Mode. So we just finished all of the report cards and now we're gonna go on to each character's endings. I think I'm probably gonna cut out the crafting stuff, except for when we actually get it built, because we all know how that works already. So I'm probably just gonna go in the same order that we went for the report cards. So Sayaka first then. Let's see how this works. Okay, so Sayaka, this time, I guess what we're doing is using the trip tickets on her, right? So, let's see how this works. And then we get hearts. Oh, and we gotta go to places now. Okay, so Sayaka apparently likes going to the dining hall or the music room. Let's go to the dining hall then. Dining alone with someone is a surefire sign, your friends. Gee, that's very intimate. Here we are at the dining hall. This is the one place where we all spend a lot of time together. What to do? Want something to drink? Oh, thank you! How about we get some cake to go along with our drinks? I saw some in the fridge this morning. It had the expiration date listed quite clearly, so I think we should be fine. Monokuma's kind of considerate, don't you think? Going out of his way to write down the expiration date. Wait, isn't that already on the freaking... Okay. Don't give him too much credit. I just want to hurry up and get out of here. It looks to me like she had a really good time. That's good. I had so much fun today, thank you! But it's more than just fun. When I'm with you, I feel like I can relax. What about you, Makoto? I really hope you feel the same way. Honestly, I think without all the killing stuff, without all of the being trapped in a school, we have to kill each other. If we're just going to Hope's Peak normally, like we were doing before Monokuma came along, the possibility of Sayaka and Makoto getting together, I feel like are quite high. Because we wouldn't have gotten to know Kyoko, and Sayaka likes Makoto, Makoto likes Sayaka, so... Well, please invite me out again sometime. It's a promise, okay? Anyway, we should probably get back. Alright, and that's the end of our day, I guess. Okay. Right, so I just did two things with Sayaka. I went to the dining hall again, but it gave me the exact same question and the same exchange. According to the guide I'm looking at, it looks like there's only 6 different exchanges that can happen, so I might get repeats. I'll try to show every different one that I can. But for now, let's go to Sayaka again then. So the questions, if we ask the wrong thing, we can get no hearts or we can get half a heart. The questions that I'm asking right now, they give me a full heart because I'm looking at a guide. If the hearts get to 10, then we'll get the ending for this character when we reach day 50, it seems like. Here we are at the music room, but it feels less like a room and more like a full-on music hall. It looks like nobody's here right now. What should we do? I am a big fan of music. Music really is wonderful, isn't it? It has the power to move people's hearts. The melodies and words join together to touch their souls. If my voice can play even a small part in that, that's enough to make me happy. It looks to me she had a really good time. I had so much fun today, thank you. But it's more than just fun. When I'm with you, I feel like I can relax. Yes, I felt the same way. Okay, I see. So these are just kind of mini exchanges. Not really anything too crazy until we get to the ending, I guess. Yep. I'd love to hear you sing sometime. What? Me? It's kind of embarrassing, but if you really want to... You sing for like... thousands of people as your job, okay? Don't be embarrassed about something like that. Maybe just for a second, okay? I was lucky enough to hear Sayaka do a quick a cappella performance. Oh, I want to hear it. It looks to me like she had a really good time. Sweet. Let's make lunch and go eat somewhere. Oh, you mean a picnic? There's plenty of ingredients here, that's for sure. And I think we're okay to use whatever we want, so I can make just about anything we can think of. When I actually get good at cooking, that is.
I was just gonna ask.
But if you're here to help me, I'm sure whatever we make will be great. Yeah, okay, she had a great time. Do you know how to cook? Do I know how to cook? Ask me later. What? Although I have had a few cooking shows offer to bring me on as a guest, so I've been studying up. What about you, Makoto? Do you cook? What? We don't know, we don't know. We don't get to know. Oh, we have something different. What happened? Why'd Sayaka get so quiet all of a sudden? What should I do? Oh, we can hear Sayaka's thoughts! Huh? That voice, could it be? Are these Sayaka's inner thoughts? Holy shit. Trigger, happy heart, okay. What should I do? Makoto, he's someone I know I can trust completely. But sometimes he can be a little too nice. If we get too close, I'll just end up being a nuisance. I hate the idea of it. I hate the idea of giving someone a reason to dislike me. But I want to know more about him. I wonder if he thinks I'm strange. I don't think today is the day. Okay, so we have to refute. What should I do? Yes, we have to refute that we think she is being a nuisance. It's a mini class trial. Of course you're not a nuisance! Sure, maybe hearing the truth or learning something about someone might change things. But I would never, ever consider that a nuisance! Makoto! I want you to talk to me anytime about anything. Don't even hesitate. Okay. You really are a wonderful person, aren't you? Thank you, Makoto. I'm not ready right now, but when the time comes, please listen to what I have to say. So that's at the end of school mode then. Definitely. I'm looking forward to it. So am I. It looks to me like she had a really good time. Woo! So today's the day, huh? Guess I better review everything one more time. The concept was Monokuma Casanova. I do have one. I do have one. How's it gonna be?
Awful! Look how you messed me up! My beautiful body!
What? Could I have made it better?
Wait, this is exactly the same as before. Nah, nah. Hey, does this look good looking to you? I mean, are you really sure? Haha! I just saw you do a not really face! Do over! Do over! Well, still, you created the backup and completed the assignment, so... I guess I'll give you some more tickets.
Ooh, yeah! Monokuma Entertainment System. We got it.
It's not even a bear anymore! This thing is supposed to keep me entertained? Okay, let's see what happens. Switch it on and... My life is a travesty. Pet me! Pet me, pet me, pet me, pet me, pet me, pet me! Come on. Shut up!
Monokuma wound up and smashed the abomination as hard as he could.
Sweet release!
Looks like the MES is blasting off again?
Man, that thing really cheesed my bananas. I couldn't stop myself from smashing it. I'm sure I don't even have to say it, but do it over! It's a total failure, but you did technically finish your assignment, so... Guess I'll give you some more tickets.
Leon? Apparently, Leon only likes going to the rec room, which is kind of bland, but okay. Oh, but Leon never even got a chance to go to the rec room. That's so sad. Here we are at the rec room. There's all kinds of games and stuff to do in here. Almost makes me feel like I'm not at school. It looks like nobody's here right now. What should we do? I'm not sure about any of these games. In general, I'm more of the outdoorsy type. Not that I can do anything about it in here. I just wanna get out of here. I'm gonna go throw some fastballs, some real screamers. Forget you heard that. I hate baseball. I think we both had a pretty good time. Still in the whole baseball denial mode. Had a good time today, Makoto. You and me get along pretty well, huh? Let's do it again sometime. It's kinda nice. I can just relax and be myself around you, you know? Alright, ready to head back? Yes, I am. Is that a slot machine back there? Whoa, it totally is! Let's give it a shot! It totally is the kind of thing a musician would do, huh? I mean, you hear about people hitting it big in Vegas and building a house in Macau or whatever, right? That kind of thing is glamorous as hell. I feel like a true musician should be good at winning slots and stuff like that. You should probably talk to Celeste if you really think that. So let's practice my victory reactions! Looks to me like he had a really good time. Damn, man, that was a blast! But feels kinda weird having so much fun in a creepy place like this. It's not normal, no matter how you put it. But screw the details! I had fun! That's all that matters! Okay, let's head back! Let's give darts a shot! Oh, is that a challenge? Actually, sorry, but I'm no good at throwing games like this. What? Hey, I know what you're thinking, but aren't you a baseball god? Well, if you think this kind of throwing is anything like that kind of throwing, you're wrong. Besides, I totally quit baseball. My mission is to become the ultimate musician. No more rolling around in dirt, mud, and sweat for me. I'm done with baseball. I'm done with throwing anything. I'm done! Oh, but what if, as a famous singer, my special talent was throwing stuff? Okay, I'll throw stuff, but just a little. He keeps lying to himself. Oh. What happened? Why'd Leon get quiet all of a sudden? Ah, damn it. Huh? That voice, could it be? Are these Leon's inner thoughts? Yet again. I know what I told everyone. I said I was gonna become a famous musician. But right now, I don't give a crap about music. What? After all this time, I just want to play baseball. I've never thought that'd be possible, but... Man, I'm so uncool right now! Just freaking pitiful. And I don't even have the balls to tell anyone. All I can do is keep it hidden from everyone till this is all over. This guy! Well, you know, people are good at the things they're good at for a reason, right? Now we know. You don't have to keep anything hidden. Whatever you want to do or want to say, just keeping it bottled up doesn't help anyone. Really? But wouldn't everyone think I was a total idiot if I told them how I really felt? I'm sure they'd see how important it was to you. No one would call you an idiot. No one would laugh. Makoto, thank you. Not that I've made a decision one way or the other, but still, I feel better. Heh. Sweet! Leon is down.
What is this? Aren't you guys all underage? Drinking is absolutely out of the question. If I find out you've been hitting the sauce, total devastation. You better believe this one's rejected. Rejected, rejected, rejected! It's a total failure, but you did technically finish your assignment, so...
Hand it over. Okay, today's the day. Moe Monokuma. We got it. I accidentally made two, actually, so...
This is Moe? It's got a certain cuteness, I guess, but something about it is off! It's wrong! So do it over!
Looks like Junko just likes going to the dining hall. What should we do? Let's make lunch and go eat somewhere. Oh, that sounds awesome! I'm totally looking forward to a homemade lunch. I thought you used the same line on Sayaka. I mean, you are gonna make it for me, right? I don't really love or hate anything, so you can just pack whatever you like. Oh, but I guess I can help a little bit if you promise to eat what I make. Yeah, Junko had a great time. Man, I can't imagine any way today could have been more fun than it was. It's been a long time since I felt this relaxed. And it's all thanks to you, Makoto. You're doing pretty good so far. You know, if you think about it, us hanging out alone, just the two of us, it's kind of like a date, huh? Then let's keep that feeling going and go back holding hands. What? She's so forward, and Makoto has nothing to say about it, apparently. When I'm starving, it's burger time. Yeah, the calorie intake is terrifying, but I just can't stop myself. Man, now I really want a burger. It actually takes a lot of muscle to be a model. Look at me, I have to keep my body nice and fit, see? Huh? Hey Makoto, your face is all red. What could you possibly be thinking about? Just ignores it. Is it hard being a model? Oh well, not really. I mean, all I have to do is be myself. And whatever doesn't look right when we're done, they can just Photoshop it out. Hey, when you look at me, does it seem like I'm trying too hard? That's not good. If I make you even think about it, I'm not doing my job as a professional. Wow, I'm surprised Mukuro actually looked into this shit. Thanks, Makoto. You made me realize I need to put a little more spirit into it. Yeah! What happened? Why Junko get so quiet all of a sudden? Huh? That voice, could it be Junko's inner thoughts? What the hell is happening to me? I knew I wouldn't be able to keep this up. None of this is going according to plan. How long is this gonna keep going? But still, I don't know how, but I'm actually kinda having fun. Aww. What am I feeling? It's so strange. It's like, deep down in my chest, I'm all noisy. I can't seem to calm down. Why is this happening to me? Is it because Makoto's been spending so much time with me? I don't think it's because of me. But what other reason could there be? And why did you want to spend so much time with me anyway? Why not just face the truth? You and I live in completely different worlds. How did she not get startled at us, like, reading her thoughts? Huh? Why'd you get so serious all of a sudden? I just, you know, feel like being serious sometimes. What's the big deal? Anyway, just hurry up and tell me. Well, I guess it's just, I'm an ordinary teenager, you know? Right? Whenever I'm with you, I feel like I don't have to be on. But still, when we talk like that, you don't think I'm annoying, do you? It's all just strange. I don't know what's happening to me. I can't stop thinking about it. Junko's acting really strange again. Well, whatever. I have fun hanging out with you. That's all that matters for now. Right. Aw, this is so sad.
Man, what the heck? This thing looks like crap!
Well, you said you wanted something eco-friendly, right? So we attached some solar panels and...
Huh? Solar panels? Seriously? We're inside! There's no sunlight! So what's the point of a freaking solar panel?
Oh, yeah.
Sorry, maybe it's my fault. Maybe the concept was just too much for you to handle.
Next
Next time, I'll pick something I'm sure even a bunch of scrubs like you can handle.
Yeah, he's gotten a little bit nicer.
It's a total failure, but you did technically finish your assignment, so...
Unsurprisingly, Chihiro only likes the library. Here we are at the library. Yeah, too bad there's not any type of like a tech room around here, huh? It's pretty dusty, but I've never seen a place so filled with books and other documents. It looks like nobody's here right now. Do you come to the library a lot?
Oh yeah, I come here whenever I have some free time. It's kinda dusty and all, but reading's the best way to pass the time for me. And people come by here pretty often too. So I get to talk to lots of people while I'm here. I think the best way to get out of here is gonna be to learn as much as we can about each other.
Without alter ego, we would have been dead, so really, Chihiro. Thank you, Chihiro.
Huh? Wow, is it this late already? Makoto, I don't know what to say.
Arigato.
Thank you for spending so much time with me. I want you to come see me again. I want to spend as much time with you as possible.
Wow, that is- you're very straightforward.
Sorry, anyway, we should get going.
I love reading.
Yeah, it's so much fun to learn about all the new things. Even if it's a book you've already read. Each time you read it again, you pick up on little details you didn't notice before. Even the picture books you read as a kid, if you look at them now, you'll have a totally new experience. Is that part of what it means to grow up?
Ooh, wow, that's a... hashtag deep.
It's so quiet here. Yeah, it's almost surprising how quiet. Maybe the room is soundproof, so nothing will interrupt our studies. You know, I used to know people who got so into whatever they were reading, they couldn't hear anything at all. I guess I get the same way when I get really into my programming. I really like the feeling of being that immersed in something.
Do you have anything that hypnotizes you like that? I wish. Yeah, I wish. That's good, passions are good.
Huh? Chihiro seems to be lost in thought, but... what should I do?
Huh?
That voice, could it be Chihiro's inner thoughts?
Oh.
What should I do? I just don't know. I want to change, I know that, but I'm just so scared. I believe in Makoto, but will he really accept me? Most likely. Everyone's gonna hate me. They're all gonna think I'm awful.
Yeah, Chihiro, out of everybody, probably does have the hardest secret to keep and the greatest burden to bear.
Why would you ever think that? Nobody's gonna think you're awful. Really? The idea that we would hate you or look down on you for something you're obviously so upset about. There's no way. And if there's something causing you this much worry, then that's what we should hate, don't you think? Makoto... I'm not trying to force you or anything, but... if you think talking to me will help you feel better, then please don't hesitate.
Arigato.
Thank you, Makoto! I think just hearing you say that is good enough for now. You've given me a lot of courage, honest! So, if something happens and I lose that courage... is it okay if I come talk to you again?
Of course, anytime you want. Yeah, aw, sweet, sweet cinnamon roll. Chiaki? Chihiro.
This thing is, I mean, you know it's disgusting, right? I don't even feel a speck of wisdom. How'd it end up like this?
We decided to put three heads on it so it could, you know, like, multitask.
Wow, what a great idea.
What a stupid idea! feel like you're just making fun of me now.
But I think it could turn out okay. I mean, maybe?
Let me go first! No, everyone do what I say! Oh, I'm feeling so lazy. I just want to eat, sleep, and play video games. I knew it! They're all a bunch of idiots! Do it again!
Just pass me the goddamn tickets. Oh, 9 tickets. Alright, next up is Mondo. Mondo likes going to the dining hall exclusively. Yeah, not that many of them actually like different places. They're pretty only into one place. Want something to drink? Oh, good call. We should take a quick break. Well, I guess this whole thing is kind of one giant break, huh? But you know, it's pretty awesome how we don't have to study or do homework or any of that shit. Oh, that was like a one-sided conversation, but okay. I don't know about you, but that was fun as hell! Oh, okay. Seriously, I never thought I could have that much fun in here. Thanks for cheering me up, man. Really appreciate it, man. Okay, we should probably head back, huh? That was empty as hell. How do you get your hair to do that? Ah, you noticed, huh? Yeah, it's kind of a bitch to get it to stay like this. At first, I could never get it to set the way I wanted it to. But my brother got his hands on some real primal hairspray, and a few shots of that did the job. What do you think, Makoto? Want to give it a shot? I think my hair is a little bit too short for that. Hey, what should we talk about? Good question. You ready for a manly heart-to-heart? We haven't really had a chance yet, right? It's okay to spill your guts every once in a while, right? Like, going into crazy detail about your favorite bikes! So, let it rip! I wanna know what you're in love with! Come on, it's fine! We're both men, right? There's nothing to hide. This seems strange. Shouldn't we be talking about our favorite girls or something? Well, you know who, Mondo's favorite girl is? It's Taka. I think we both had a pretty good time. Yeah! It's fun screwing around like this once in a while, right? I mean, as long as you're there to screw around with me. Yeah! That was the last of our bonding, so... What's going on? Looks like Mondo's lost in thought. Give me a break. Huh? Are those Mondo's inner thoughts? Give me a fucking break! What the hell am I supposed to do? Is he talking about... Once I get out of here, what then? Right now, I'm the leader of the Crazy Diamonds, but after that... What, am I gonna go to college? No chance, right? I've spent my whole life running wild, just causing trouble and fucking shit up. But now, I want to do something with my life. I want to make stuff instead of breaking it. But if I told Makoto that... I bet he'd just laugh at me. You know what? Eh, Makoto would not laugh at you, but you know who would? Hajime would. I won't laugh at you. What the hell are you talking about? Why would I laugh? Want to see how serious you are about all of this. You don't have to hold back, man. I'm not holding back anything. I think it's amazing how determined you are. Really? Thanks, man. Yeah! It's always good to encourage people. Today's the day! The concept was Warlock Kuma. Whoa! That is not a Warlock Kuma!
What the? He's not even a Monokuma anymore! Fine, whatever. You finished it, so I guess I'll give you a reward or whatever. But it's already been 50 days, you know. This whole thing seems totally pointless. Maybe I should figure out another approach. Go ahead and waste your time however you want till we're all done.
4 trip tickets.
Seems like you've been working really hard. And to reward you for all the effort, let me give you this.
Oh, thanks.
Now to use that. Well, you don't need me to tell you, right?
Alright, so if we look at this... Boom! Now we have 5 people. Mondo, Leon, Chihiro, Sayaka, Mukuro. And hopefully, we're on day 50 right now, so hopefully once I get through today, we will see something about the character, something more in-depth.
Today is day number 50! You have reached your deadline! Even I and my infinite patience have grown sick and tired of your uselessness. But still, your teacher will not abandon you. I will begin making preparations for tomorrow. Because tomorrow is when your real school life begins. Boo, boo, boo! I just can't wait! So for today, please get plenty of rest to prepare for tomorrow.
Bye! Good night. Alright, day 51. What's gonna happen?
The morning of the 51st day arrived, and Monokuma told us all to head to the gym.
Good morning, everyone!
Good morning!
As you all should know, today brings an end to the period of time I promised to you. But it sure was a long time, huh? You all got up to this and that, that and this. Of course, that's only because you were slacking off instead of focusing on building decent backups. Ugh, I was ready to die from boredom. That's a worse way to die than reaching out to grab a salmon than slipping and tumbling over a waterfall.
If you were so bored, why didn't you just make your own backups?
What? What did you say? What did you just say? I'm just flipping angry right now!
Huh? What the hell, man? We totally made you a backup!
You did? You made this? You created it? You assembled it? To put it more succinctly, this was you? This is no Monokuma! It's a stupid pink rabbit! Are you trying to deny my entire existence? I didn't ask you to put your own spin on this!
If you are going to criticize us for our creativity, I would suggest you give us more concrete instructions.
Yeah, seriously. It's like you handed us a sketchbook and gave us some vague specifications and now you're all mad.
Indeed, if you're gonna complain about it, build your own damn backup however you see fit.
I guess I have no choice. Your real school life is gonna have to start now! I didn't want to have to do it, but I guess I'm gonna have to lift the ban.
Lift the ban? On what?
On something that should make you all work a little harder. It looks like the carrot I put in front of you isn't working, so it's time to put the stick behind you.
Are you talking about some kind of punishment?
Well, you guys deserve it, don't you? You didn't satisfy my requests even a little bit!
You're the one who kept demanding all that silly shit. Without all that, we would have been fine. Yeah, quit trying to blame us for all this.
Blah, 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 all you want. My mind's made up. From this point forward, each time you fail your project review, I will select one of you to be the class representative, and that person will be punished.
Punished? What does that mean exactly?
Huh? Oh, well, to put it simply, execution.
Nani? Execution?
Surprise, huh? I guess it's time I showed you who's boss.
What? You can't be serious. You can't kill someone for something like that.
What's the big deal? I just moved the schedule up a little bit, that's all.
The schedule? What the hell are you talking about? So all of this eventually leads to the regular school life anyway.
That part's still a secret. So, for now, let me just announce who will be punished this time.
What? You're lying, right? You can't be serious. You're seriously gonna punish us?
Didn't you hear me the first time? What? You got caught in your ears? Okay then, who should I pick? This kidding! I already know. Today's punishment goes to... Makoto! You're up, big boy!
What? Hold on a second! You're gonna punish me? How come?
Well, see, an average useless kid like you either dies first or turns out to be the main character. So this time, let's make you the one that dies first.
You can't be serious. He's right, Makoto. You already had your chance at being the main character, so...
Okay, let's get this show on the road!
Wait, this isn't... Why are we...
Well then, I've prepared a very special punishment for Makoto Nagi, the ultimate lucky student. Let's give it everything we got! It's punishment time! Hold it!
Huh?
I won't let this tyranny go on any longer!
I was wondering about this, cause during the ending for Danganronpa 1, the credits rolling, I saw Monomi right after Monokuma. So I was wondering when she would show up. There we go. What the? Hey, what's going on now? That robot we made, did it just... It moved and talked! What is this?
It's a miracle is what it is. The miracle everyone hoped and wished for.
Huh? You heard our wishes? Then you're alive? What are you? Hold on. Does this mean... Wait. Does this mean Monomi was made by the class in Danganronpa 1? Or is this really just an Easter egg thing?
I am Ushami. Specifically, the amazing messenger from the future, magical miracle girl Ushami. Now listen here, Monokuma, it's time to give it up.
Yeah, she has her stick now.
But you're not supposed to show up yet. If you make your entrance now, the timeline's gonna get off. No questions allowed.
Oh! Is Monomi or Ushami gonna win for once? Oh!
Hey, knock it off! Are you seriously gonna try to finish me right here? Now, for the coup de grace! The Ushami final splash bark!
Yeah! Who's gonna win? Oh! No way! No way!
Justice always prevails!
So all she needed was the stick. We gotta find her that stick.
This wasn't supposed to happen until the sequel! I hope you've learned your lesson, mister! Stop all this nonsense and let them go! Okay! Here, take it! Do whatever you want!
Monokuma handed something to Ushami, then left on wobbly legs.
Huh?
What the hell? What did we create, man? Is it gonna go out and destroy the entire human race? It's a good question. What are you?
Let's see. I represent the bond you've all created here. And that bond itself represents a fragment of hope. The light from each of you has overlapped, creating me, a road sign leading you from the future.
Future? Like the Future Foundation?
You did great, everyone!
From the future? What do you mean by that?
That's not important, and since it's not important, I don't need to tell you! Now put your collective hand out! I have something for you!
And what she gave us was the same thing Monokuma had just given her. This is... It is some kind of device. If I had to guess, I would say it's...
That's right! Press the button, and the door in the main hall opens up wide!
Oh! That's the button that Junko left us, but in this one, we just get it right off the bat. Then... We can leave? Yeah, boy! I'm so happy! It was a long, hard road, but finally... I'm just so glad we all made it here together.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's awesome! Super awesome!
Finally did your job for once.
Usami watched us all celebrating, a smile on her face. I had no idea what Usami really was, but one thing I really did know is that she saved us. Which is why I wanted to make it a point to thank her. Usami, thanks for saving us. We owe you our lives.
Hello?
Oh, you don't need to thank me. You're the one who brought me here. And now, from this point on...
Huh?
We... Actually, never mind.
What happens in two? Are you thinking about something?
Ina-san.
Listen, everyone. All the time you spent here together... All the time you spent building up your hope, your bond. No matter what, don't lose that.
Love, love.
Love, love. Don't give in to despair. Please just do your best.
Usami? Hey, she just stopped. Did she run out of batteries? That can't be it. We never installed any kind of power supply. Huh? Then how did she move around in the first place? Stop talking! This is totally all a cult! Maybe he's right. But no matter what Usami was, she stood up to Monokuma and saved us all. It's not always true, however, that the enemy of your enemy is your friend. Ugh, why do you gotta ruin things every freaking time? Can't you just say nothing and let us enjoy this? Anyway, let's get the hell out of here! Good idea! Monokuma might change his mind and come back, and then we're all in trouble.
Yes.
Alright, then let's get ready to split!
I was just about to say that! Everyone started getting ready to leave. Meanwhile, I turned back to Usami one more time. Usami... But there was no reaction at all. It was like everything she'd done before was just a hallucination.
Naegi-kun.
Makoto. Huh? What is it, Kyoko?
Ne.
What Usami told us. The bond we created here. That bond is a fragment of hope.
Oh.
Demo.
What do you think she meant by that? I can't be sure, but... I think she meant the connections we form between each other. That's where hope is born.
So.
Our connections are... hope? To share a connection with another, that creates a light that can dispel any darkness.
なるほどな.
And that light illuminates the road into the future, is that what you're saying?
Yeah.
The connection between a few people might just be one little fragment, but... the more people you bring together, the brighter that fragment can shine. Yeah, I think you're right. Over these last few weeks, we've all gotten something from each other. I know that much for sure. Before we arrived, each of us was a tiny little fragment, scattered throughout the world. We each had something we were trying to carry within us, alone. We had no idea that the consequences of that kind of thing led to despair every single time. But that's what we learned while we were here, while we worked together hand in hand. All it takes is holding someone's hand in yours, and that despair starts to fade. And if it doesn't go away with two people, then three. And if that's not enough, just keep adding more. And now, we're all going to leave here together, just like that. Huh? Junko, is something wrong?
Oh.
Huh?
No, I'm fine.
Hyotoste?
Oh, you're probably thinking the same thing I am. No one's thinking about donuts.
Once we get out of here, is everyone gonna go their separate ways, or will we stay in touch? I mean, we're all friends now, right? So...
Asahinayo.
This is not a final farewell. The time we spent here together, the memories we created, will always be real.
Yeah, Sakura's right! If it's too sad for us to part ways, then let's not part ways! Yeah, we should meet up every once in a while and talk about the good old days! That sounds like fun! Yes! What a splendid idea! Renewing old friendships is an excellent way to enrich your life! Well, I don't really want to remember anything about this place.
Oh.
Well, it's not like we gotta just sit around remembering stuff, right? Anyway, it is still far too early to be planning that kind of thing.
That's true. First, we all have to get out of here. And we can each go back to wherever we came from.
Uh-oh, but the outside is still...
That's right. Back to those boring, peaceful, incredibly important days. Together with everyone else. That fragment of hope each of us had buried within our hearts. The future born from that hope might have moments of despair. But even so, everything has to begin from there. Maybe I should talk with everyone a little more before we go.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yep, these are the 5 people we managed to get 10 hearts with. So maybe they have a little something extra to say to us.
I decided to talk to Sayaka one more time before we all left. I wonder if this is the last time we'll ever see this place. The time we spent here didn't make much sense, but looking back, I can't say I didn't have fun. There are still some mysteries left. What was Monokuma really? Why did we all end up here? I still don't have answers, but I'll have time to figure all that out once we escape.
It's finally time! But it took so long just to get here!
You mean to the gym? Ugh, to the gym!
No, silly! What I mean is, we're finally ready to leave Hope's Peak Academy!
Right, sorry.
No, it's okay. I'm sure what I'm saying doesn't make much sense. But what I'm feeling doesn't make much sense either. I feel like so many miracles had to happen for me to get out of here.
You got that right.
I can't explain the sensation, but... Why?
Sayaka. I feel the same way. You know, I'm really happy I get to be here with you.
Me too. For so long, I've been waiting for the day when you and me could meet and walk down the same path together. But in the end, I decided that fate had decided we wouldn't be together. And yet here you are, standing right next to me. So many miracles have come together to allow me to be where I am. But the whole time, I completely, absolutely believed it would turn out this way. Do you know why? I wish I could say I did. Because of the promise you made, that we would get out of this together.
What? I said that?
No, not exactly.
Huh? Then...
I sensed you making that promise, some version of you.
Yeah, that version of me didn't save that version of you, though. And that version of you tried to kill me. Or frame me.
The things you said, we'll get out of here, whatever it takes, absolutely. I heard you say all that.
Yup. Yes, this is from the main game that we've seen already.
If that happens, I'll get you out of here myself, no matter what it takes.
What was that? Did that conversation ever really happen?
No, but somehow you remember? Me and you.
That's why I had faith. I knew that until we reached this future, you would never give up. So, thank you. I'm happy now. So happy.
A single tear rolled down Sayaka's face. You know, I think I made another promise too. Sayaka said she would be my assistant. And I promised that we would work together to get out of the school. But Sayaka, sorry.
Why are you apologizing? You didn't do anything wrong.
No, I did. I made you wait for so long. I definitely have to apologize for that. Oh my god, it sounds like they're dating already.
I'm sorry for making you wait.
Makoto.
I knew you were gonna say that.
What? Cause you're an esper?
I knew everything. I knew you would never give up until it was all over.
That's why I was able to go through with this. Why it didn't hurt.
Because
I'm psychic, you know? I was nearly blinded by Sayaka's smile. Whatever problems I might run into from now on, as long as I have her with me, everything will be okay. If there were any miracles, it wasn't because of me. It was because of her and everyone else.
Why? Why? Yes, I want to talk to everyone else. Come on, Junko. Junko, Mukuro. Yep.
I wonder if this is the last time we'll ever see this place. Yep. Junko, is everything okay? Huh? Yeah, everything's fine. Why? You're the one who decided to come and talk to me, right? Oh, well, I just thought you seemed a little different than normal. If there's something bothering you, you can tell me. I might not be much, but I'd be happy to listen.
Oh, what is she even thinking here? I can't even.
Makoto, if I said that we should stay here together, what would you do?
What? Why would you say that?
Don't worry about it, just tell me. What would you do? Would you stay here with me?
Hold on, why would you want to stay here? I mean...
Didn't you want to search for a new dream? After we got out of here? You're right. But when you think about it, the idea of chasing a dream is just too vague. There's no substance to it, no clue what it even means. You just end up desperate and lost, and then everything you've done is a waste. Besides, before I ever find out what I'm looking for, the world might come to an end or something.
The world might... What do you mean?
Oh, relax. It's just a silly metaphor. But still, it's not like you to get so scared imagining stuff like that.
Scared? Me?
That's how it seems to me. It's okay to get lost. It's okay to keep searching. That by itself is better than not even trying. You said that, remember? So why are you so scared now?
Stop talking, Makoto. I'm not scared. And of course I remember. I said it, didn't I?
I mean, sure. I do want to believe that there's something better waiting for me out there. Which is why... Anyway, I have one more question. From this point on, no matter what happens, even if I don't seem like myself, will you stay by my side? I can feel her eyes boring into me. Someone, they feel different from the Junko I'm used to talking to. But seeing her standing in front of me, there's no doubt she's the same friend I've come to know. What are you talking about? You've never been anyone but yourself. You're the same girl I've known all along. Who else could you be?
Hey, Makoto? I don't understand a word you're saying, you know? But it's okay. I think I get what you mean. But are you sure about all this? I've always been a disappointment, at least according to her. But now I'm all alone. I just don't know what to do from here on out.
You're not alone, Junko. I'll always be by your side. We can walk together, searching for that dream. And if we get lost, if we run into trouble, we can do that together too.
I'd like that.
Thank you, Makoto. But she still looked troubled somehow. All I wanted was to make her feel better, so without thinking, I took her hand.
Huh?
She looked surprised, but then she gripped my hand in response, so tight it hurt.
When you look at me, when I feel your hand in mine, I know that I'm real.
Junko. Oh my god, Makoto's getting all the girls. The Junko I'd seen before, and the Junko I was seeing now. It was almost like there were two of her. I feel like she must have a secret, one she can't tell me just yet. But no matter what it is, no matter what happens, I will never let go of her hand. On my own soul, I promise.
Jesus, what? Why? Why? Oh my god. Is this basically just Makoto getting all the girls? Let's see. We have Leon. Yup. Hell yes! Finally, we're getting our asses out of here! None of this made any damn sense, but it's over! Yeah, you're right. But man, what the hell was Monokuma's deal? And I guess I originally came here to, you know, go to school. But I didn't want to go here anymore anyway, so whatever. Really? Uh-huh. What, you don't believe me? No, it's not that. But graduating from here is like being on the winning team, right? Why would you want to throw that away? Oh, well, I already decided. I'm gonna go back to playing baseball. Aww. Does that make me lame? No, not at all. I think it's a great idea. Thanks. I just gotta beg my old team for forgiveness. Leon looks really happy. But there's something I'm worried about. Oh, by the way, can I just say one thing? Aww. Sure, what's up? What about singing? I'm assuming not, but are you gonna keep singing? Aww. Huh? Yeah, of course. What, did you think all I was gonna do from now on was play baseball? Oh, well, it's not like I doubt your dedication. I just thought it'll be really hard to focus on baseball and singing at the same time. Black. Don't you understand? That's exactly why I have to do both. Huh? An athlete can only play for so long, you know? Even as the ultimate baseball star, I know I won't be able to play for the rest of my life. Oosh. But when you're a star player, you have the chance to go on talk shows and stuff, right? Pitch for a while, then go on to become the ex-baseball star who's totally a famous singer now? It's a totally new approach, huh? Yeah, it's new, that's for sure. Right? Not just a baseball star, and not just a singer. It's an all-new approach, just for me. But, you know, the only reason I was able to figure out this new approach is because you were there to listen to me all those times. That's what I think anyway. But I didn't do anything. Come on, don't say that! You're getting a huge thanks from a future superstar. Just accept it. Leon was grinning from ear to ear. He was beaming. Okay then, I accept. Nice! Seriously, Makoto, thank you. I'm sure that from now on, no matter what challenges Leon might face, he'll conquer them all. His smiling face, standing there with me, talking about the future. That's an unforgettable symbol of our hope. Why am I getting everyone's underwear? Oh my goodness. This is weird. Chihiro. Will that device really let us escape? I'm sure of it. We just have to believe in Usami. You seem really excited, Makoto. Well, I get to go home. What? Is it that obvious? Yeah, I've never seen you with such a wonderful smile. I bet you have all kinds of stuff you want to do once you get out of here. I can feel that desire overflowing from you. Well, I'm sure you feel the same way, right? Chihiro? I don't know. I don't know what I should do once we get out of here. I have a goal, I know what I want to become, but how to reach that goal, I have no idea. Makoto, what should I do? Just let yourself get immersed in it. Yeah, we talked about that, didn't we? I do feel like I'm starting to understand, but still. Listen, Chihiro, you don't need to rush things. Just keep your goal in front of you and move toward it at your own pace. Changing your outlook is good, but it's not as simple as just rushing headlong towards something. It's okay for you to figure out the right speed to move at. Makoto,
Even if that means taking things slow, as long as you don't give up, you'll always be making progress.
Yeah, you're right. Thank you. I feel like maybe I'm not afraid anymore.
That's good. I'm glad I could help.
Then, do you mind if I take my first step right here? If I don't do it now, I feel like once I get outside, I won't be able to do it.
Of course I don't mind, but is it really something you can do right here?
Yeah.
Chihiro closed her eyes, took a deep breath, and let it out slowly. And then...
I want to tell you something, Makoto. If you can, please don't be too surprised. I'm a boy.
Huh? What do you mean?
Well, I'm actually a guy.
Oh!
Makoto?
What?
Oh, sorry! I scared you, didn't I? But, I mean... I didn't mishear you, right? You just said you're actually a guy? Yeah, I tried to be more like you. Does it not suit me?
It's not even about it suiting you. I mean, since you're a girl.
No, I mean it. I'm a guy.
Listen. I don't know why now of all times you're trying to be funny.
Hey, Makoto, what are you doing, man? You're right. It does seem like a joke, doesn't it? But it's the truth.
Tears stood in his eyes, but his face was determined, unwavering. Chihiro wasn't joking, that much was clear. But at the same time...
If you really want proof, you can go ahead and check.
Check? I mean, I obviously can't tell just by looking at you. Are you saying I should touch? I can't do that!
Then...
To just believe her! Him. Hold on, Chihiro! Without warning, he grabbed my arm. I yelled out, but he ignored me and...
Ah!
Pushed my hand up against his chest. Huh? But the shape, the form I expected to feel, wasn't there.
Now do you believe me?
Yeah. I was still confused, so confused, but I nodded.
Imagine Mondo off to the side looking at us right now.
Chihiro, he was a man, no different from me.
I did surprise you, didn't I?
Well, I'm surprised you're a boy, yeah. But I'm more surprised at how bold you were.
Well, that's... It's just because I had to be. To become who I really am. To have the strength to tell the world who I am. To reach my goal. So, can I tell you my story?
From there, Chihiro explained how he had taken on the identity of a girl. He told me how he'd been teased for being frail, so frail as a child, and how that had... And how that had affected him. He told me how he retreated into a feminine identity and embraced the assumed weakness of it.
But being here with everyone, talking to you so much, I decided that I wanted to change. I didn't want to be weak anymore. I didn't want to lie to anyone. I wanted to become my true self so that we could all become true friends.
Chihiro. So, Makoto, after hearing all that, it might just cause you even more trouble, but... Even though I pretended to be a girl, even though I've been lying to you this whole time, will you still be my friend?
Of course.
Yes, of course!
You mean it?
I respect your strength and your courage so much.
Respect? No, I'm not that strong. I don't think I could tell anyone else but you.
Don't say that.
Huh?
You're stronger than anyone I know. It's hard for anyone to acknowledge their own weaknesses, you know? But you faced your weakness, and you took steps to overcome it. So don't say you're not strong, because you are.
Makoto.
Arigato.
Thank you.
You're always there to encourage me like this. Whenever I get scared and want to stop, you're right there behind me, pushing me forward. So, until I'm strong enough to be my true self in front of everyone, I hope you'll be there to support me.
I wish you came to me and not Mondo.
Maybe I'm just being naive, but... can we keep spending time together like this? Just talking about whatever comes to mind? Absolutely. We're friends, right? You can talk to me about anything, whenever you want. And I feel like I can talk to you about anything, so there's no reason we can't stay close. I'll be counting on you too, okay? Okay. We may not always be there for each other individually, but we still have to work all together. We know we're not alone, which helps us work harder even when we are alone. And embracing that hope, we take step after step into the future.
Oh. Yes, let's talk to Mondo and end this off. Yeah, we're getting a good bit about everyone individually, so that's nice. Even though most of it, I think we already got before. It's almost time. We're almost free. Yeah.
Ooh.
Now I can get back out on my hog. Damn, man, she must be so lonely. I'll have to take extra good care of her once I get back. So, are you gonna go back to the Crazy Diamonds then? I told you, didn't I? After everyone in the gang graduates, I have a new goal. You're gonna become a carpenter, right? Cause he wants to make things, not break things. Right. I've destroyed so much stuff, man. Now it's time to start creating it. It was tough for me to admit it at first, but now I don't even care if you laugh at me. I'm not gonna laugh. You're a hell of a guy, Makoto. Oh, I know. Oh, I know. Once I become a world-class carpenter, I'll come and build you a kick-ass house. Better look forward to it. That sounds awesome. I'll be waiting. It's a place for my best friend to live, so I'm gonna give it everything I got. So, till then, don't buy a house, okay?
Wait, what? But, so that's it?
Huh?
Yeah? What else is there?
Oi, oi.
What? You think I can't become a fucking awesome carpenter?
No, not at all. I know you can do it.
Damn straight. Alright, then it's a promise. A man's promise. Aww, no more promises about men and whatever. Whatever it takes, I'll become a friggin' amazing carpenter and build you a friggin' amazing house.
Mondo thrust out his hand. I held out my own, and he gripped it tight and gave it a powerful shake. We can't know what's waiting for us out there, but as long as we have hope, we'll have a future.
Alright, I'm not sure about how to feel about these undergarments, but
And that's how my life, my school life, at Hope's Peak Academy, came to an end.
Oh, and that's it. Alright, then I guess when we come back, we will look at the other characters. Which might take a while, because there is quite a bit of grinding involved. So hopefully I'll see you guys before, you know, December rolls around or something. See you soon.